What's up, everybody? You're back with The Chosen Con. And today in the studio, we have my boy, Manny Baya.
Correct.
Yes. Okay.
You got my last name right.
Yeah, for the last 2 years, I've been saying Bahia, or year and a half. Okay. I apologize, man.
No, I don't really apologize.
So now we have you in the studio today. We just did our podcast.
Right.
We dissected a lot of different things. The first thing was your journey. And so I wanted to, I guess, maybe just briefly touch on what did you do when you were a kid, man? When you were in elementary school, what did you spend a lot of your time doing?
Oh, man, just, you know, the usual things in South Vancouver, just playing outside, playing, you know, street hockey, playing basketball, you know, baseball, things like that. But also at the same time, we got a computer lab and we got internet access in like grade six.
Yeah.
When I was in grade six, and I just started playing around with that and started building websites, myself and a friend.
So you started building websites in grade six, man. That does not sound like a small feat. Now, yeah, I feel like a bunch of kids probably do that now, right?
Probably. Like it's easier now.
But back then,
we had to code that stuff, man.
Yeah, you coded it, and you said dial-up internet, too.
Dial-up internet, man. You know, someone calls on your dial-up.
So it's all crap. I was coding, for God's sakes. Yeah. Would it still save? Like, if the internet did, disconnect?
Nah, sometimes it would just go away, man.
That was so I didn't know that.
It was what it was, but that's what you use, like, you know, Word or whatever, like Notepad or something to kind of save it. But yeah, I mean, it was cool, man. It was just like growing up. Yeah.
So you did that, and then you were telling me that you would do something every morning in high school, and when you'd be eating your Pop-Tarts, what was that?
Yeah, when I was eating my Pop-Tarts with my bowl of cereal, I'd be, you know, reading the newspaper and just flipping through it. I was a news junkie, and I just love being informed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that goes, I guess, it coincides with the future. Where you went as a kid, you were coding, you're making websites, you're taking on the news. What were you doing in university? You were saying that you and your really good friend, what was his name? Your partner?
Oh, Carm. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, when I went to university, I was to become a software engineer. First semester, took an elective, microeconomics. Told my parents I'm switching to biz as my major. They were like, "What? After one semester? You know, the engineer blood. Come on, what are you doing?" But they were super supportive. You know, I found business to be much more fun and challenging. And then a few years into university, myself and my co-founder Karim started a blog called Van City Buzz.
And what is like, what is a blog? We talked about it quickly. What is it?
Man, it's like an article or like a website with a bunch of articles and just people's personal opinions and things.
And
it's
what did you
a
guys
collection of it?
What did you guys start talking about back then?
Oh, back then, man, we just started with topics that we knew about, things like, you know, sports and like real estate and politics. And it was a little bit more opinion based back then because that's essentially what a blog was.
And why did you guys like? Why was it needed? Like, why did you think that, you know what, we got to do this?
There was a big void in the market, man, where people, there was all these traditional media sources, but no one was really informing people of the cool people doing cool things in Vancouver. And so we had a section called Vancouverites where we would highlight, you know, successful Vancouverites or even photographers and artists and models and a whole bunch of different people that make the city for what it is. And so we found that, and also events and things to do. No one knew of some, you know, the free events or the family events or the, you know, the concerts or, you know, club nights and this and that. And so we wanted to provide that information to Vancouverites.
That's powerful, man, because you brought up a lot that you're an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
And so you solved the problem.
Yeah, man. It's just, you know, it started as a passion project and a hobby, and it grew to what it is today, man. We stuck with it, man. It's all about, you know, consistency and patience, right?
How long did it take you from when you began to when you paid yourself?
6 years, man.
6 years.
Yeah, yeah. Any profits we made, we reinvested into the company, hired other employees, even got an office that we weren't even in because we had our other full-time jobs, and kept growing the business because we wanted to get to a certain point, and then eventually, you know, jumped into the deep end, and I went on full-time August 2014. And then I told my co-founder, Carm, I'll get the revenues up, and then you're jumping on full-time. A few months later, you know, we got it up beyond expectations, and he jumped on full-time, and then it just went hyper-speed from there.
That's crazy, man. Just like understanding in the podcast your whole journey to an extent and getting to that point.
Yeah.
And then what else we talked about on the podcast was about media and the day and age that we live in now.
Yeah.
Right, and how it's changed. And so you were telling me about just like the echo chambers, and you were telling me about how the opinionated, like how those kids are making money. So you want to dive into that briefly?
Yeah, briefly. I mean, I guess what we discussed is that media since the beginning of time has been a business. Even if you look at papers from the late 1800s, they had content in there that was paid for, but it wasn't even marked as paid. And so we've had that issue for over 100 years. Now most recently we have obviously the internet, easier to disseminate news and content out there. So, I mean, you can have anyone and producing and crafting, news of any kind, whether it be real or fake, and monetizing it. And so we've seen that the past few years and leveraging social media to get it out to the masses. And, these echo chambers get created, when you're on, let's say, a Facebook, where your friends are all are like-minded as well, and you guys are liking, commenting, and sharing the same content. And so you keep getting that content over and over again because the algorithm says that's what you prefer.
Yeah.
And then you never get to that diversity of thought of seeing another person's perspective. So that creates issues.
A lot of issues. And you talked about diversity in the podcast too with your team.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So you're saying that your team is from all different walks of life. What was that like?
Yeah.
Different perspectives.
Oh, it's awesome, man. It's way better that way. You get different perspectives and see different points of view. I feel that, you know, a newsroom should reflect, if you're city-based, the city that you're from, mm-hmm. and the makeup of it, and shouldn't just be that one lens, looking through it and deciding what to write, and how to angle things and this and that. It should be a diversity, a background diversity of thought and messaging.
And you said something too, something very powerful about getting your news from different sources.
Yeah.
Right. And so what would be a piece of advice for people? How should they, I guess, consume it, or where should they look? What would be different sources in your mind?
Yeah, I would, even if you don't agree with a certain news source or publication or whatever, just try it out. Just see their perspective,
yeah.
and get it from multiple sources, your news, and then discover your own truth, because, yeah, there's a lot of false information out there. And it's up to us, and hopefully, you know, with the social media platforms and some sort of government regulations and this and that, that we get more fact-checking and truth out there. But for now, it's important to look at all perspectives.
Nice, man. And even to, before we end off, giving back, what does that mean to you? Like, since now you've been doing all this stuff, you're an angel investor too, you have all these interesting things happening, what does it mean to you to give back?
Yeah, man, giving back in different ways, right? Like, for example, giving back to, you know, my friends and family that are around me as well, that supported me all these years, and all the sacrifices that were made of me not being at certain events and, you know, just working and grinding. Listen, I don't want to be the only one that, you know, achieves success. I want everyone around me to be successful as well. And that's why I do support so many different businesses, you know, from, you know, my family and friends, and my community. With my friends, like even some business partners, I'll give up, you know, this allocation and investment. I'm not greedy. Like, you know, I want you to make money too. You know what I mean? Or I'll give up equity in a certain business as well, because I'm thinking about growing the overall pie. It's just about what fun is it if you're the only one, right, achieving success. It's way more fun if everyone's achieving success, right?
Yeah, it's better to eat with everyone than eat alone.
For sure. And then in terms of, like, yeah, just giving back and hoping to, you know, inspire youth, because obviously growing up in the 80s and the 90s, didn't really have any role models, right?
No, I can only imagine what the role models are like. And you know what, I think with the timing now, a lot of young people, they need role models in different sectors.
Oh, absolutely. You'd be surprised at how many people within, let's say, for example, the South Asian community are achieving so much success in downtown, man. Like lawyers and accountants that have just excelled and are at the top. Even like I know this one kid from Abbey who got invested from Mark Cuban. No one in the South Asian community even knows.
Yeah.
But there's an outlet there, and it's really important for youth to go beyond their comfort zone of, you know, their neighborhood, of their city, and travel and learn and meet new people and network and expand, and self teach themselves.
Yeah, that's something that in this whole podcast, you, I guess, reiterated multiple times as being a student.
Of course, man.
Always learning.
Have to.
Right. And I, man, I learned a lot from this podcast. My mind is just like, no, I'm serious though. I actually mean that from your journey, but also from all the different things in regards to media, because you're right. What we feed our mind is crucial.
Absolutely. I mean, media is so powerful. It has influence. It shapes your mind, your perceptions, you know, who you're going to vote for, what you think, what restaurant you think is good, everything.
Oh man. If the restaurant don't have the reviews or the media hasn't hit it. Yeah, you're right, man. I'm not going to go to that restaurant.
Yeah.
Right. That's powerful. So I guess to end off, what's the last thing you would say to the people watching, in regards to following their dreams, man, or following their passion?
Yeah, just, you know, continue finding inspirations out there. Continue being hungry. Just look to win and nothing else. Continue learning. It's okay to fail. We failed a huge number of times in the past, from little decisions to big decisions, but you get back right up and you improve. And you just be right more times than you're not. And keep going out there and battling. Find your passion, man. Find out what you love to do every day, because yeah, there's a point in time where I didn't. And I, like I said in the podcast as well, I'm a bad employee.
Yes.
Like, yeah. But now, I mean, I can't sleep because I'm too excited to, like, you know, for the day and what it's going to bring.
You can see it. It's The Alchemist. I always bring it up, but it's just like you're living your personal legend.
That's a great book. I read that one.
It's a damn good book. Yeah, but it's in your eyes. You can see when someone's actually following their heart or following their passion.
Right.
So hopefully that everyone that is watching, like, you can get one step closer to doing all that. To contact Manny or whatever it may be, I'm sure you, Daily Hive, they can find you somehow. Yeah,
Google me, you'll find me.
Yeah, you'll find. But yeah, just check out the full podcast. It's going to be on Apple, Google, all of that. It's interesting, right? This is the first podcast we've done in a while, so for me, this has been nice, right? I'm fasting right now too, but the amount of information, the things that I learned from it, I think a lot of kids, a lot of South Asian kids as well, are going to benefit greatly from it, man. Right?
Oh, thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you again. All right.
Awesome.
All right. We're all done then. Peace, everybody. Thank you for watching our videos. Your support really means a lot to us. Check out our podcast and honestly, check out the other conversations we've been having as well.